Hi, I'm Adrian. Today I will show you how to use parameters in NextReports Desinger. For this tutorial, I will connect a local database running on my PC. You can connect to any database, as the procedure will be identical. Browse to the queries in the database and open one. For this example, we will use the timesheet query. For more details about creating and using queries in NextReports Desinger, please see our How to Create a Query tutorial. Let's say that we want to see all the employee names of employees working on a specific project. For this, we need to add a parameter where, at runtime, we will specify that project. To add a parameter, just click on the plus sign in the parameters section. We will name this parameter project. We can also give it a runtime name if we want it to appear differently to the user. Next, select the source using the column selection button. In the column selection window, select the table and the column containing data for your parameter. Optionally, you can select a second column in the Show Columns area, whose values will be shown to the user in the parameter selection panel. I will choose to display the name of the project, but my parameter will actually use the project ID column. In the selection field, you can let the user choose either one value for the parameter or multiple values if needed. I will select single, allowing only one project to be selected as parameter at runtime. I will also check mandatory, so the report will run only if a selection is made. If you need to add some additional information, type it in the description field and then click OK. To use our parameter, we have to add a criteria on the criteria column. Right-click on the specified cell and then check the parameter option from the pop-up window and click OK. Next, we have to select the output column checkboxes for the information we want to see. Now, run the query by clicking the Run Query button. The next window will ask us to choose a value for our parameter. I will choose one and click OK. In the Query Results area, you can see the results for the selected parameter. Notice that the report also includes the employee ID and project ID columns, which don't look great. To hide them, I will go to the Query Desinger and uncheck them in the output column. When I run the query again, I will only get the project and employee name columns. NextReports also supports chained parameters. Let's say we want to display the name of the employee, the date, the number of hours, and the workload the employees in the project given as parameter, so I will check them on the output column. We need to add a new parameter just like before and give the name employee. This time we'll select its values through an SQL query. We will choose multiple to allow selecting multiple values and optionally fill something in the description field. The runtime parameters order can be modified from these two blue arrows. We have to add a criteria for the second parameter in that column. Right-click on the column and add criteria, then select the parameter defined earlier for this column and the operator that we want. The operator and the parameter type should be correlated. Now run the query. In the pop-up window, we are prompted for the parameter values. When we select the value for the first parameter, the values for the second parameter will dynamically fill that column. Select a few values for the second parameter and click OK to see the results. Thank you for watching the Parameter NextReports Desinger tutorial. Goodbye!